Barry, if something good can come from last week, does Dover need to be a watershed, a low moment to make sure that these things don't happen again?
Yeah, I mean, it was disappointing. We've reviewed the video. The players have, you know, held their hands up and said they take responsibility for, you know, losing goals at the set pieces, which is a positive for me. We did well to get back in the game, so it was credit to the players for getting back in the game. But, you know, as I say, they've held their hands up and they know that they've got to take responsibility for the set pieces and who they're picking up and, you know, how organised they are on the pitch at that time.
So you've seen that determination from the players to put things right, that they, you're expecting a response this weekend?
Yeah, well, we've had a good week's training. You know, we've shown them what's expected again and, you know, worked on it. But it's, you know, down to them when they cross that white line to have that determination, you know, to make sure that their man doesn't get a free header, or, you know, the organisation or who's picking who up has already done, they know what's expected of them in that sense. It's down to them to take that onto the pitch. So you can work on it in training, but it's when they cross the white line and game day that it really matters.
There is that individual responsibility, of course. Is there any, without getting too technical or tactical, is there anything that you are looking to do differently, maybe man-to-man to zonal, which sometimes seems a recipe for chaos in itself, but you're not changing your methods?
No, man-to-man marking, you know, and it's a player's responsibility when they mark that man. What we have shown them is that, you know, from the video, we've went too deep from the free kicks. We're sitting in the edge of the 18-yard box and we don't have to be, which causes its own problems. So we've worked on that, you know, to a certain degree this week. But it doesn't matter how deep you play, how high you play. It's all about marking your man when the ball comes in that box. And we didn't do that well enough on Saturday.
And with a fully fit squad, possibly again this weekend, are you looking to make changes to freshen things up, not rotating the squad for the FA Trophy, but just the fact that it's the next game?
It's the next game and it's a game we want to win. We're at home. Whether we make changes or whether we rely on the boys, you know, be a decision we'll make, you know, by the end of play today. I know my own thoughts, but, you know, given training and what we're working on, if guys don't step up to the plate today either, then that can change my thoughts.
The FA Trophy is a good opportunity for another cup run. I already know the answer to this. How do you approach the competition?
We want to win it, you know, but first and foremost, we've got to get through this round. It's a tough game. I think the last five games we've played, five out of the top seven, including Eastleigh this Saturday. So it's been a run of tough games. We all want to do better in these games, but we have to accept it. Or, you know, realise that there have been difficult games that we've been playing in. That doesn't mean that we're not frustrated and disappointed with the results. It just means that, you know, we'll have to respect the teams that we've been playing against as well.
Yeah. And some teams see the trophy as devalued. They'll maybe put out a weaker team, but there's a chance for some footballing glory as well as financial reward, and that's got to be incentive enough.
Yeah, I think it's our next game and we want to restore pride from, you know, what was a disappointing result down at Dover, and that's as far as we'll take it. It's a cup, you want to go as far in the cup as possible, so we'll feel the strongest side available.
And we lost narrowly to Eastleigh here at the Ebb earlier in the season. Do you expect a similar type of game? Clearly they've got resources, as we saw, they're able to bring players off the bench who can make a difference, but it's those fine margins once again. Do you expect a similar type of game?
Yeah, you know, it'll be a competitive game. They're sitting fourth in the league, so it shows they're in a good running form. We've got a new manager from the last time we played. But I always believe that, you know, we've got good enough players to win the game. But it's on the day and making sure that we're disciplined in everything we do to give yourself every chance of winning it. As I said previously, to get ourselves back in the game last week was, you know, it showed a lot of commitment from the players. But we just have to make sure that we defend properly when the chance of when it arises.
And I said it at the time, it was a crazy 100 seconds. I suppose the key is to harness whatever brought that about and extend it for longer than 2 minutes.
Listen, I don't think it was a great game of football. It was windy down there. you know, but as I say, players, Dover switched off, we went and put them under pressure, which we didn't do enough of. But that's last week's game. Yeah. We're focusing this week, and you know, we fully expect, you know, a better performance overall in everything we do in Saturday.
And finally, how are the squad looking? Is any Knox niggles?
There's a wee bit of illness going through the club at the moment. We'll give them every chance of being available. Joe also played in the Hampshire Cup with a young with the youth team on Tuesday, and he came through okay. He just came off because he was tired, so it's good to get him as many minutes as possible. Whether he's ready to start the first team match, I think it's a wee bit too early to say, but we'll see how he is today and we'll take it from there.